poetry is about aspiring, being something more than what you are or what you want to be.
Run, whirlwind, run. Further and further away into the sun.
There are two panels today. The first panel will focus mainly on poetry educators themselves or other kind of creative arts education, just because there is a major overlap and they suffer the same challenges.
Don't you know?
Them, you know, like a peek of the world that they might venture into after school. And you know, they have a lot of like different kind of problems and stresses and their issues, like cats, the bomb in the bedroom. I love that idea. It's very important for these people to have space.
My head teacher got up and made a speech, and what she said was, this has allowed our students to express their feelings. And that was what she saw as valuable. But I do think that because they saw that, okay, this is something that doesn't need to be scary. This is something that can be exciting.
It's about the linking. It's how we link them together, because they're all there already. It's not about erasing one system to put in another. It's finding a way to bridge both.
Because obviously parents are also a huge influence. Now you talk about teachers, you talk about students, but you do not mention how many parents that you have changed in terms of mindset towards their kids or poetry and language in general.
But my experience running the center here is that I get parents coming and say, you know, my child is getting up early to come to class. So that's a shift. So a lot of times it takes small shifts for parents to realize, oh, this is working for the child.
So like if language is a problem, you introduce movement.
Yes.
And in drama we have this thing called tableau, right? Where you create still pictures based on concepts or context that you want to introduce.
I went to a public school system. I was lucky because my teacher brought me to a poetry event many years ago.
To regain your attention besides the food, I think, is to actually have a performance by a spoken word poet.
That my brains would understand that failure is not an option when you are a minority. 10 A1s are necessary.
Then the second panel, I've invited other language or literacy educators from Malaysia to also have a discussion about their challenges and also their strategies.
Songs about girls like you.
All developed countries emphasize the importance of practice and promotion of the art, and as a country, Malaysia is acknowledging that.
Unfortunately, it's difficult to find teachers who understand the same perspective. What we do is we try and be as independent as possible.
What we try to do is that just give them all these artsy fartsy things.
Thank you to you guys. I hope that we have somehow talked about challenges and somehow we can see the doors opening and where we can help each other.
We're gonna invite some young people up to the stage.
Hi, my name is Kat Brogan. I'm a spoken word educator from London. I applied to the British Council and to the Arts Council of England to run this forum in partnership with Poetry Café KL. I'd like to inspire people in Malaysia to find out more about what's happening in this country to do with spoken word and poetry education so that we can use words and young people's voices to open the minds of the next generation.